It is almost incomprehensible for me to imagine that New Zealand would pass legislation that reflects so much fear of some foreign force. I had no idea New Zealand had so many enemies. I had no idea New Zealand was under attack. I had no idea New Zealand had suffered under 9/11.
We are very pleased that the relationship between New Zealand and the United States is growing stronger.
The controversial GCSB bill has passed into law by 61 votes to 59. The Green Party called it a sad day for New Zealand.
This bill condones the illegal invasion of the privacy of each and every person in New Zealand. This bill is not constitutional. It is not consistent with human rights.
Last night, the Prime Minister wouldn't or couldn't confirm or deny whether the GCSB uses a surveillance program called inexcusable. Is the GCSB using or does it have access to inexcusable?
Well, I'm not going to answer those questions.
Why not?
Because I don't go into, and no Prime Minister has ever gone into, what techniques they
actually
use.
So I'm taking that as a yes.
At the top of every page of the top secret document, five countries are listed. The USA, Australia, Canada, Great Britain, and you guessed it, New Zealand.
Well, we know from the leaks from Edward Snowden that the US government is basically committing mass surveillance on the world population. Everything that traverses through their networks is being captured. Every email, every phone call, every chat message, every SMS of every New Zealander and everybody else. Here's the thing, you cannot preemptively turn every person into a suspect and go and snoop in their personal lives. And you know, you might think you have done nothing wrong and you have nothing to fear, but if someone really has something you know, against you politically, they don't like you, they will look through 5 years of your emails and they will find something.
Over the past several months, leaders of countries all over the world have been discussing inexcusable spy networks and communication interception laws. 8 months ago, New Zealand was rated number one in the world for its freedom. Freedom which was fought for by Prime Minister David Lange in 1984 when the US was pressuring New Zealand into allowing nuclear-powered ships to enter New Zealand waters. As a result of your country's bravery to refuse United States demands, the US government suspended the ANZUS Treaty, which froze United States and New Zealand economic relations. It was this brave stand that has given your country true independence and moral high ground. Why should your government give in to such a power like the United States now? What has changed? The leaders of your country are being manipulated and corrupted. Do you really want your leaders to take after a country which is carrying out illegal and immoral practices, a government which tortures and orders drone strikes upon innocent civilians, a country which is carrying out mass surveillance on every single person in the world, including their allies? We as Anonymous are disappointed with the actions of your government. The passing of the controversial GCSB Amendment Act was a clear indication to us that we needed to intervene. On Thursday the 22nd, Operation Fuck GCSB was initiated, and on Friday we disabled the GCSB website for most of the day. This was downplayed by the media due to more deception from a GCSB employee. Following the pass of the GCSB Amendment Act, it was made public the US military had an interest to build a new undersea cable from New Zealand to the United States that would allow greater amounts of data to be transferred between the NSA and GCSB as well as other paramilitary regimes. In the wake of recent privacy violations, one can only assume it is to continue such operations more efficiently and more effectively. Police affidavits related to the raid on Kim.com's mansion appear to show that New Zealand police and spy agencies are able to tap directly in the United States surveillance systems such as Prism to capture email and other traffic. Prism, a tool used by the NSA to collect private electronic data of users from services like Gmail, Facebook, Outlook, and others, gained international significance this year after classified presentation slides detailing aspects of the program were leaked by a former NSA contractor. The U.S. government has insisted that the NSA is only permitted to collect intelligence on non-U.S. citizens overseas, but critics of the program say that the government's broad classified collection efforts capture too much incidental data belonging to innocent Americans. At the top of every page in the top secret exciscore documents, five countries are listed: USA, Australia, Canada, Great Britain, and New Zealand. The scope of the data mining operations is far-reaching and ever-growing, and it is clear that New Zealand is more involved with mass surveillance than anyone thought. To the government of New Zealand, you have our full attention, and we are watching your every move. Violating the people's right to privacy will not be tolerated. To the citizens of New Zealand, due to the inevitable corruption of your government, we have decided to broaden the scope of our NZ operations. During the next week, Operation Kiwi Freedom will come into full effect. Your right to freedom and privacy shall not be suppressed because of pressure from the United States government. You live in a democratic country, and we as Anonymous will do everything in our power to remind your government that they do not control their citizens, that they are not in charge of our rights to freedom as human beings, that the people should not be afraid of their government, the government should be afraid of its people. We must stand together and unite against these violations. This struggle is not yours alone, but for the whole of mankind. It is time for the citizens of the world to unite in one voice. Stand up to the oppressors and defend your rights any way you can. As long as there is one of us standing, we are legion. Do not give up your rights, do not turn away from the fight. They will try to vilify us in our quest for justice. Do not believe the propaganda. Research for yourself. Seek the truth. Operation Kiwi Freedom. Initiated. We are Anonymous. We are Legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. New Zealand government, you should have expected us.